thing that's good to know about Storyboard Pro is that if you know where a command is in the top menu, then you can easily find its keyboard shortcut, as it's always listed right beside. So if you're using Mac, obviously the keyboard shortcut corresponds to Mac, whereas if you're using Windows, these keyboard shortcuts will correspond to Windows. However, if you'd like to customize a keyboard shortcut, you can do this by going to the top menu and selecting Storyboard Pro, Preferences, or if you're using Windows, then the Preferences option will be under Edit. And from the Preferences panel that opens, you have to stay in the Shortcuts tab. So the first option that you have is to choose between Storyboard Pro shortcuts or Harmony shortcuts. If you're used to using Harmony and you're new to Storyboard Pro, then you might want to switch these shortcuts to the Harmony shortcuts, as you're probably more used to them. Now if we look below, something you can do is search through these lists, like an index, for tools or commands or the shortcuts of certain tools and commands, especially if you are unable to find these items in the top menu. You can also assign keyboard shortcuts to functions that don't already have one, or change the keyboard shortcut to a function that already has one assigned. So for example, the line tool does not have one, so I can select that. And then I can click my cursor in the press shortcut key field and then press any combination of keys. So I'm going to press Alt D only because I see it here for the dropper tool and I know that it's already taken. So we can see that a message warning box comes up that says the following action has the same shortcut key, the dropper tool, in the drawing tools category. So you have three options after that. You can either replace the line tool with the dropper tools keyboard shortcut. You can duplicate it, in which case they will both have the same shortcut, or you can cancel. So in this case, I'm going to cancel, and it automatically clears the field. So instead this time, I'm going to click back in the field and then try Command L. So no message warning has come up, so that looks like a safe one. If I decide I don't want to use Command L, I can always clear it. Or I can always go to the default, and this works more when you select a tool like the dropper tool that already has a keyboard shortcut. If I clicked in here, cleared this, gave the dropper tool the keyboard shortcut Command L, and then decided I wanted to go back to the default, what I could do is go to default and it'll bring it back to Option D. So let's go back to the line tool and give it that keyboard shortcut one more time of Command L. And the other thing that we're going to look at really quickly is also that you can search for a shortcut either by the name of the command or by the name of the shortcuts. So if I want to see if there is another Option D, what I can do is I could click on the shortcut radial button and then click Option, then D. So not simultaneously like when you use a shortcut, but one at a time. So then you'll see that a bunch of text appears in the message area, letting us know what tool this shortcut is assigned to. Were there no tool, then the message field would remain blank. So we know that this has been assigned to something else. I can also search by name. So I can search for line tool. And we can see that the software found it by the message and shortcut that appears. And you may have also noticed that not only is there a column for the name and the shortcut, but also the default. So if I had changed the dropper tool, we would see its current shortcut and its default shortcut. So what it was before. So I'm going to say okay. And now that I'm back in the interface, if I use that keyboard shortcut Command L, we see that the line tool has been selected in the tools toolbar and that I can now draw with the line tool.